coding.
And what about me? I was on university there. Just to check out one or two applications leveled against the Muslim students on campus. I'll be heading to the park now to get a bus straight to it. Finally, I arrived at the university after 3 hours stressful journey. Standing in front of the Mozambique Hall, which is a hostel for the females, and I'll be taking a walk towards the area where the Muslim sisters pray. This is just to confirm and show that technically the area where they pray is not in the male hostel as reported. So, I believe the school should actually be happy that the students all pray in one place, because if they have to pray in their rooms scattered all over the place, it won't be organized and probably they will be disturbing some others. So having a particular place to pray is actually advantageous to both the students and the school. But why the school is currently taking this action of accusing the students wrongly of prostitution, which is a very, very vile accusation, especially to Muslim sisters, is unknown to us. So, as like I said, as alumni, we've decided to come and confirm and see by ourselves. So I'm currently at near the entrance to the female side now. And this is the entrance of the female. So as you can see, technically it's not in the male hostel. I took a walk directly from the female hostel to the entrance of the mosque, and from the entrance of the mosque back to the female hostel. And I'll be going through the sister side to make some verifications about how they use the place and probably if there's truly a hidden room as reported in the media. Actually, I'm an alumni of this institution, which is what necessitates my worry as to if things have changed from how we left them. So now I'll be approaching the entrance, the female entrance of the mosque. Usually the entrance is usually locked. As we all know, the Muslims don't allow free access to wherever their females are. But due to this recording, I've actually requested for it to be opened for me. So as you can see, the first, I guess this is their tutorial center. I see their press board. Okay. It's the first tutorial center here. And we have another tutorial, the second tutorial center here, also in the mosque. Okay. I guess this is the ablution center right here in the mosque also. And this is still the female part of the mosque. They have this part of the mosque since there's no provision for the female mosque in the female hostels, so this place was cordoned off for them. And here is where they observe their solar. So, people have some books and something like that. Contrary to what we got in the media, I don't think there's any probably hidden room or whatsoever visible from here, except maybe underground, if there's going to be anyone underground. So this will be all for the female side. I'll also go to the male side to do one or two checkups too. This is the male entrance of the Old Hall Mosque. Okay, we have their press box. Oh yeah. Let's go inside and see. We don't need permission. As you can see, their door is wide open since this isn't the female side. So as you can see, there's no hidden room anywhere. This is the ablution center of the male part of the mosque. Tutorial center, one of the tutorial centers in the male part. Another tutorial center. So, I believe it's obvious if any secret or hidden act is being performed. Definitely it won't be secret anymore. But people can't be around here as well, and probably you'll be having hinos or bad acts being performed here. You can see people are worshipping. You have those that are studying with their laptops. Probably they're preparing for a class. And those that are worshipping and citing the Quran.